I was saying this in a seminar in a church, and someone stood his hand and said, "But Pastor, I've heard that if you compliment someone, that person is going to be proud." My friends, it's the opposite. Why people are proud? Do you think that people are proud because they feel secure, because they feel important, because they believe in themselves? No. They are proud because they feel inferior. Their pride is an attempt to feel important. It's an attempt to compensate this feeling of inferiority they have. So behind a proud person is someone who doesn't value himself. Because the person who really values himself, he won't show off. Because he doesn't need. He knows he is important. So why does he need to show he's important? He doesn't need to show. He knows that he is. And when you know that you are important, you don't need people to tell you are important. What you are going to do? You are going to tell them that they are important. You are going to make them feel important. And the best way to do this is complimenting. But what am I going to compliment? I don't see anything good about that person. How can I compliment my son? He's always doing something wrong. Oh, he does something wrong. You know, you don't compliment only because you see something good. You compliment to see something good. It's the power of attraction. And it's really interesting. Something that I discovered too. You want your son to be something? You want your daughter to be something? Say that he is, that she is already what you expect him or her to be. It's really, it's like a magnet. And I discovered this about my daughter. I want her to be more responsible. I say that she's responsible. I give her a good self-image. I give her a reputation to live up to. And after I say that, she wanna prove that she is. So my friends, the power of compliments, the best, one of the greatest powers of the universe. Give people a good reputation to live up to. Compliment these small things. Never let something without you recognizing that is small thing, compliment all the time. And you're gonna see what a blessing. And since I talked that about this research, that you need at least 3 compliments to heal a criticism. And I have heard about another research that says that it's necessary 5 compliments to heal a criticism. So if you really have to criticize something, what could you do? What should you do? Thank you so much. That is exactly the answer I wanted. 5 compliments first. 5 compliments first. And other thing is your attitude. Because it's not only what you say, but it's the verbal, the non-verbal language, the way you say something. Because sometimes you put like the hat of the know-it-all, right? Or the glasses of the physician, you know? I understand your problem. It doesn't make sense. How can you do that? I'm not like you. Oh no, I don't do that. You know, you see how I do this, but you, wow. So, you are putting yourself above the other person. And this is why, sometimes, before criticizing someone, you know what you should do? You should criticize yourself first. Yeah. We are so prone to criticize people, and sometimes you forget how hard it is to be criticized. Sometimes we forget that we are without air and we want to break the windows. And the person says that we are wrong, the person starts criticizing us, and we want to change the subject. Or we want to criticize the person back. And we try to defend ourselves and say that she's wrong and she's the problem. So my friends, this is why I need to be really humble. You need to say, you know, I want to tell you something, but I don't feel the right to say, because who am I? I have so many mistakes. For example, you can say to your child, you know, when I was your age, I also had some difficulties, and especially this one that you have, I had too, but I want to share with you what I learned through my life. One father told me something really interesting. I went to a church one time to do a seminar, and this father wasn't there. His wife was there. And I was selling, at that time, some cassettes, some tapes with my seminars. So his wife bought those tapes. And when she got home, she showed him, and he took the tapes from her. He took to his car, and he was going back and forth, driving, listening to the tapes one time, two times. Well, then I went to that church another time. When I went there, he was there. And he said, thank you for the tapes. And he told me, you know, I was in some home some days ago, and my son did something really bad. But then I remembered your messages. And instead of criticizing him and doing what I would like to do, because I would like really to criticize and to be really hard on him, I said to him, my son, I love you very much, and I'm proud of you. You are a very good son. But you did something wrong. But I know that you did this not because you wanted to do, but because you didn't know that this was wrong. So I'm gonna tell you that this is wrong, so from now on, you know that things like this, children like you don't do. Because you are good, and good kids like you don't do things like that. And I'm sure that from now on, you never do that. So you realize how he called the attention of his son. How he criticized his son. Actually, he didn't criticize. He complimented him. He said that he was a good son. So that kid learned that he was wrong, and he still felt proud about himself. Because the father gave him a good reputation to live up to. So my friends, we want to show that our kids, that they are bad, they do bad things. What are we saying to them? We are taking away their dignity, their sense of respect, of value. And you are what you think you are. You want your kid to be a good kid. Don't say that he's bad, that he's wrong, that he doesn't do anything right. No. Compliment him. And you're going to see the power of compliments. You're going to see the power of the word, the power of praise. And this is what we see in the Bible. When God says, when he created us, you are very good. Very good. And when he says that we were made in a wonderful way, oh my friends, we have in our hearts the seed of victory. We have in our hearts the image of God. And I want to tell you something, the importance that you show people that they are the image of God. That you show them how important they are to you.